This video and stream is proudly brought to you by whatisZS.com. ZS is coming soon. As soon as we get our factory reset back up after the pandemic. Yeah, she's still a bit of a nightmare trying to get everything back up and running. So we will get there eventually. We do apologise for the delay in the release of this product. Okay, friends, subscribers, and all of you YouTubers out there, man, oh man, I know a certain YouTuber that's going to get in lots and lots and lots and lots and lots of trouble. See, in Australia, right, we've got certain laws about certain cases going to air and things like that, certain rules about what can be publicly shown of a court case and everything, but it looks like it has to be a staff member in the Texas judicial system that's doing this. There's someone within the judicial system that is doing this. I believe it is a female, because there have been videos where she has spoken. And and because these cases are being done on Zoom, they are easy to record. So whether or not it's the judges that have to record these cases, which I gather they do, but someone within the system is sharing this information publicly, and that's against the law. How do I know it's against the law? Because after I saw it, well, the first thing it come against, I saw, like, I'm just watching, like, these entire, you know, all the videos that most of us blokes are watching now, checking out what's going on with all these stupid females of this time, what they're doing, the most, how would you say, delusional and promiscuous females, and trying to warn my son and my mates about what's going on and everything, but most of them know about it. But yeah, I came across this video, Texas baby mama filed child support and look what judge ruled. Now, I'm not gonna actually go into it too much, but I'm gonna just go through and you'll see their little brief little thing, like documents are being shown, pictures are being shown of these people. This poor dude's actually in prison, right? His details are publicly being shown on YouTube. Right, YouTube doesn't have any rules about it, but the courts and the legal system certainly do. And whoever you are, Pink Book Lessons, get ready for the FBI to knock at your fucking door. And yes, I'm swearing because I think this is the biggest fucking breach of any legal system I have ever fucking seen. And I mean, it's a joke. It is dead set a joke. There are full cases from this channel. You just have to go through the videos and look at it. Case after case after case after case of sensitive documents, sensitive cases that have been recorded on Zoom because of the pandemic. This person has gone out and publicly shared all these people's details, because a lot of these cases turn around and show the documents. They actually physically are showing the documents. The judge will say, okay, I'd like you to show the document, present the document. They come up. And this is details that are protected under the law. And even in America, and yes, I had to go to American law to look at it. And I'm into reading law. I've fought a couple of court cases and one. Beat an insurance company. Yeah, I love that. got told by the judge I did such a good job. Well, I got a big head for a day, but all the other solicitors were told that they should take an example from me. I was congratulated by about 10, 15 solicitors after the court case. And no one had ever seen a person represent himself as well as I did. I just didn't tell them that I was actually trained how to do it for a couple of weeks. But because I'm as smart as I am, yeah. And, yeah, so, Mike, okay, these cases are being publicly shown, mate. Whoever this is, and I don't know if you're affected by it or whatever, you want to go through this channel, make sure your court case is not on here, Mike, because if your court case is on this, right, anybody on this channel that has had their video done, right, the video about their court case, right, anybody that is appearing on these videos, you have massive, and I've been talking to a solicitor all fucking morning, you can sue the fuck out of the legal system, you can sue the fuck out of the people that did this, right? This channel one should be barred. I'm writing to YouTube in regard to this today, but the FBI, I gather, is going to want to look at it. And the FBI, if you're out there listening, and you're going to be listening, because guess what, folks? They know. The FBI, well, will know. Hang on, just let me up the size of that so you can all read it, because I've not only written to the FBI, I have written to the Texas governor, because a lot of these cases are in Texas. And here it goes. It says that... yes, to the Texas governor, I'm an Australian YouTuber who is about to do a story. Here's the story. We're doing it right now. On a fellow YouTuber, as I believe what is being done is a breach of trust of the court system. It's always been my impression that court cases in these instances, i.e. child support, are private, should never be publicly shared, and everything like that. And let's just say the American Act is the same. It's very similar. I think actually the American Act is a bit stronger, and this person is definitely going to jail. And if you are affected by this person, you want to sue. I'd say there's going to be a massive class action against this person and against YouTube, because YouTube shouldn't have allowed this, against the court system, against the person, against the government, against the state. Because this is truly the biggest breach I have ever seen of any law. And this is stuff that where child's names are being mentioned, people's details are being mentioned. As I said in one of these videos, the dude is in jail and his information is being plastered all over the net. And one of the biggest things you're told in life, never share your information on YouTube. This person is actually doing it for everybody. But if... And I put pretty much, at first when I first thought it, I thought it was a skit. Until I started looking at other videos. And when I started looking at the other videos, I found it. So then pretty much after I've done it, I'm sort of going on and, yeah, just sort of said I thought it was a skit, but realised that this person is constantly publishing these details just for YouTube. I've got to fix that typo. And I believe that this is the biggest breach in history in Texas, and I'm about to break the story on YouTube, which I'm doing right now, as I believe this is happening. If this was done here, the person would be responsible, would be in jail for a very, very long time. And they'd go to jail for, yeah. This is most probably one of the biggest breaches. If you do this in our country, you're up Schitt's Creek. And if you do it in America, you're up Schitt's Creek. And that's what they've got a secrecy law just in regard to these cases. So, yes, I'm reporting this YouTuber. It's Pink Book Lessons. Go to, if you are on child support in Texas, go to this lady's channel. Especially if you have done a Zoom meeting in regard to your court case, over the past 2 years since 2020, when the pandemic began, you have a definite, my solicitor says, you all have massive cases. And yous are all going to make a lot of money out of this. Most probably pay for your child support for the rest of your bloody life. You want to sue. If this was me, if I was a victim of this channel, I would be suing the shit out of them myself. But yeah, so yes, this, my phone number will be added. I'll put my name and everything on there. I don't mind you seeing that because you already know all that stuff about me, but that will be added, and I should hit the wrong button then. That will be added after I finish this video, and I'll put my details, everything in there and everything like that. But it is definitely going to the FBI. It's very hard to contact the FBI, by the way. It was one of the hardest things. I ended up having to go to the media coordinator to try and get this through to the FBI, because someone trying to email the FBI about something is wrong. But here it is. Secrecy provisions. Everything is in here. Protected information. The whole lot. People covered by the provisions. In other words, every staff member at the court is covered under these laws. Authorised representatives. It's sort of, you can disclose to other parents. Then it's got a thing to a person. Where is it? Yeah, it can be communicated there. The whole lot is in here. But from what I've read, nothing says you can publicly go and put it on YouTube. But the person is definitely a court person. There's no two ways about it. As I said, you only have to look at the videos. Every one of them is on child support cases. Every single one of these videos. And okay, then the other court cases, yeah, as well. There's a couple of other court cases in here. So whoever this person is working in the court system. Like, oh, there's a case from Nashville. I think that's in Texas, isn't it? Nashville? I don't know where Nashville is. But let me know in the chat, guys, if it is. G'day, Loyalty. Yeah, if you know anybody that has done a Zoom meeting about this, yeah, let them know. Sort of, because this is thing, but it's not, does Mike, it looks like it's not just in Texas. I thought it was just in Texas, but a lot of the cases are in Texas. And it's got to be a staff member. It must be a staff member. There's one lady that does appear in a lot of these videos. That's that lady there in the corner, top lady where the mouse is, her. She appears in quite a lot of these videos. I'm wondering if it is her, but it is definitely someone within the legal system, inside the Texas judicial system, that is releasing these videos. There's no two ways about it. You've only got to go to the channel. It started up only when the pandemic started, about 2020, yeah, July 2020. When all the court cases and everything were moved to Zoom and everything to protect people. But the whole thing is, look, you can see the judge, he's there. It could even be that if it's the judge, I tell you now, he's definitely going to go away if it's the judge doing it. But the thing is, it's sort of, you've only got to look at different things. But it's not just that one. There are other court cases, but the child support ones, they are protected under American law. And that's wrong. For that sort of information to be being publicly made, this is truly one of the biggest breaches in the legal system in the history of America. And I'm sorry to tell you, whatever you call them, pink books, you're going to jail for sure. There's no two ways about it. My solicitor didn't know too much about the law in America, but he did put me onto this page here, because he was the one that put me onto this page here. And pretty much, if you do this in Australia, expect to go to jail for sure. There's no two ways about it. Hang on, there was something about Australia in there. Services, this means that Services Australia can make a record of personal information needed to administer to a child support Australia services. Yeah, I mean, is that the right one? Oh, hang on, I've just put up the wrong one. Sorry, I put that's the Australian Act. Sorry, what have I done with the oh, God. That was the Australian one. Sorry, I don't know what in the hell I've done with the American one. Child Law, Family, Attorney General's Department. I think that might have been it. Sorry, I've closed the page down without realising it. I do apologise.
So there's multiple laws and everything. So yeah, in Australia, it's illegal. In America, it's illegal. So, because he sent me two pages, I don't want to go into the email because it's going to give out his information and everything. So, yeah, but it is definitely, against the law. There's no two ways about it. Every country, you can see it, every country has got protection acts against this happening to you. And it's wrong. It's sort of just in Australia, as I said, that's the Australian one. And I am very sorry, but I've lost the FBI one and I can't open it up while I'm streaming. So I do apologise. But the other one goes on about, it's very similar to this, extremely similar to this. I was looking at it and just going through showing shit. This is actually illegal, and he did check, because he did send me the American one as well as the Australian one. I just think, because I was going through both. And in most countries, this is covered by law. You cannot publicly share these meetings. You cannot publicly share things in court cases without express permission from a judge. And I know that happens in America as well. And trust me, the FBI and everybody is going to be investigating this for sure. But this is just for Australian government. And just look at the provisions at what is there for the Australian law. And I wish I knew, and I don't know if it's still in history because I've cleared the history as well. Because I was trying to keep, trying to keep everything private to myself. And I do apologise that, folks, that you can see that I've looked into this big time, and it sort of says that something is going wrong with this system. And American law. I'll see if I can find it this way. Goes through. Yeah, he had to. It took him a while to actually find the document as well. Oh God. Where is it? Because I know it actually specifically even referenced Texas. So I'm trying to find it. All right. Sorry, guys. I'll try and find it. I'll list that document in the description the moment I find that document again. As I said, I cannot actually get it up at the moment whilst I'm actually on here. But as I said, I've reported it to the FBI. That's the best I can do. And and report it to the Texas governor as well, because a lot of these cases are in there. And but the thing is, it's just shocking that someone within the court system, if this is a judge publicly sharing these things, a judge must rule that the case can be shared, and what can be shared. But when it comes to documents, that's in any country. No document within a court case can be publicly shared. In this particular video, the baby daddy is currently in prison, and his details were shown publicly on the internet. And it's wrong. It is 100% wrong, and it should be investigated. And I truly believe that this is going to be a very big case when it gets to the governors, because I'd say they'll be investigating as of the moment that they get this information. Because when it comes to child support, child cases in nearly every country, they are protected because they are minors. The only time that their information can be publicly broadcast, like if they've committed murder or something like that, and they've been thing, and generally it's only the end of the sentence that you ever see on the internet. But whoever this person is has thought, well, I can make money out of this, and there, because you've only got to go to her about page. And as I said, it is definitely a woman, because you've only got to listen to one of the videos. I'll tell you now, watch these videos, because they're going to scare the shit out of you. I will put the link to this in the description to her channel and everything. And I'm sort of in the process of trying to do that at the moment. I'll have to take that. And, but the thing is, it's sort of, have to find the American one. Sorry, I've just got to put this in there. Because I'm going to have to refind it, go through the email, find that exact document again. Thank you to my solicitor for doing that for me. Thank God my solicitor is one of my friends. So it's sort of, he doesn't even represent me. I don't do anything wrong, but he's a solicitor. So yeah, I get a lot of advice from him. And he's been pretty good over the years. And but to actually see all this and actually... Yeah, it could be a bailiff, it could be a clerk, loyalty. Support court. Oh, wow, so there's another one. Support court. Yeah, well, in Australia, it's illegal. And as I said, in the document that I read, that I accidentally shut down before I made the video, because I was shutting down all the videos that weren't relatable to this, the only thing I didn't shut down was that NASA image of the alien on Mars, because I'm still researching that one. But the thing is, it's sort of, you've got different things, you've got FBI. But the best thing I can do is just report it. It's sort of, as I said, in Australia, our law is very, very strict. And that's the thing. You need to understand this, because there is an actual Secrecy Act. And that Secrecy Act, and I'm 100% sure, is the same in America, similar but thing, because it sort of, it might say it differently, and I know it did read differently, but the page was almost like this. It said, what was it, American, it had the American symbol, you know, the one that you guys have, similar to ours. We've got that up in the top corner. It had yours up in the top corner. Pages set out differently. But that's just the Australian one. And these cases are so protected because children are involved in these cases. And as I said, I just wish you could read what I read in the American one. It sort of pretty much virtually said this person's going to go into jail. And because in any court, a lot of the time, things have to be ruled by a judge that can be publicly shared. But I know for a fact, private information of an individual cannot be shared publicly from any court hearing unless that has been ordered by a judge. And you see cases like that all the time online about someone's information and everything like that being publicly shared. They go to court and they sue. And in America, you sue more than we sue. Here, if it happened here in Australia, that person you'd never see that person again. They'd most probably never get out of bloody jail. Because in our country, if it's a public member of the courts, held accountable in our country, and I believe it should be held accountable in yours. And I'm so sorry that I turned that damn page off. And it just makes you wonder that what is truly going on in this and everything. So contact your governor in Texas, guys, if you are affected. Do what you can to fight this, because this is wrong. This is publicly wrong. And this person should be held accountable. Yeah, but it's the, and not shared on the internet, and shared on the, cannot be recorded. Public can attend. But see,
loyalty, these are Zoom meetings. So the only one that can get it is somebody within the system. Because it's not... When I first saw it, as I said, I thought it was a skit. Because I'm just looking at it and everything, and I'm looking at these and seeing the fake backgrounds, and I just thought it was people. And then I started listening to it and everything like that. But seriously, they go through and they talk about it. But this dude appears a lot in these videos. This dude appears quite a lot. So does this lady. She appears a lot as well, as just as much as the judge. So someone within the American system is actually doing this, and it's wrong. It truly is wrong that people's details are being shared publicly. Their court case about children is being shared publicly. As I said, in Australia, it's definitely a jailable offence, and what the American details said in regard to the secrecy of these cases, pretty much the same thing. And I do apologise for turning the page off, because there was about 60 pages up the top of the screen when I, up here, when I, just before I did the video, and I'm just shutting them down willy-nilly, like all the movies I was planning to watch that day and everything. They are in my history. But, yeah, I don't want people to see that, okay, yeah, so what, I want to see Harlock, but I watch a lot of these delusional videos about women and stuff like that, and that's, yeah, because I've been through this shit, so I know all about it. And it was just by chance, this one was in the side column over here. So I clicked on it. And because it says, Texas file for child support, and look how the judge ruled. But then I and it's not far before that. It's only a 9-minute video. I am putting a link to this video. I'll just put it in there now. I'll put it in the description. So the link to this video, I put the link to the channel, I think, already in there. So, it's, yeah, just, you've got to ask yourself if and when that, what can be done. So you've just got to ask yourself, really, what can be done, how it can be done, but it definitely needs to be reported. Like, if you see anything like this ever, and you're a bit iffy about it, do something about it, for God's sake, because this should stop. It really should. And like, as it is, I'm seeing too many court cases appearing on TV and everything like that. But they are legitimate court cases where they are a TV show. But now we've got this person, they're wanting to create their own YouTube show of people's private information and things like that being publicly shared. So I strongly recommend, if you are a victim of this person's channel, do something about it. Contact your FBI, contact your local authorities, and do something about this person. Because this person, is definitely, from what I've read, is breaking the law. And I'm seeing to it, as you can see, I have that email. I'll finish that email and send that email as soon as this video is finished, which I'm about to do in a second. Because, my voice is going. I've got a lung problem and I'm waiting on a delivery of medicine. So I'll have to get up in a minute anyhow. So, have a look through it, go through it. I'll slowly add these links. It could take me a little while to find the link. I'm going to go through the emails, because I've had a few emails since then. And I'll make sure I link that page in this description for you, so that all the Americans, you can check your laws in the states and everything like that for the sharing of your court case thing. Because as I said, just look at the Australian one, in regard to the secrecy that's involved with the Australian one, will scare the living shit out of you. So it's got to stop. It really does. This sometimes kids' details, school details, and I have seen school details in these videos. I went through about 20 of this person's videos and everything like that, and like I was feeling sick.
And I really was, because I've been through a court case like this, and I've been through a court case a few times like this, because I've got five kids. And unfortunately, I've got five baby mamas, because I used to be a nightclub manager, and I used to be a, they call them fuckboys now, they used to call us root rats in the old days. But yes, it's, yeah, freaky that this is happening, folks, and it must stop. So anyhow, look, I'm going to end the video for now. Thanks for watching, and I've got a lot of other videos planned in regard to what's going on Mars. I've got a few other things going on, and I will have a couple of cannabis protester videos being recorded on this channel, because I record them on this channel and put them over onto the protest channel, because I don't have as many viewers, and I like you guys to pop into the chat. And yeah. So anyhow, thanks for watching, guys and gals. And Loyal, a friend in America, has just said this is crazy because each case would have to be declared a mistrial. Thank you, Loyalty, for that. So there you go, folks. As you can see, Loyalty's comment in the chat that this case should be declared a mistrial. All of them should be, because they've been publicly shared and shit like that. But anyhow, folks, look, if you are affected, do something about it. Do not stand back and don't do anything about it. It's your legal right. And sue the bastards. Sue them good. I love all my subscribers with all my heart. You all make me happy and everything. And life is tough at the moment with YouTube and everything like that. I don't ask for donations anymore. There's links in my channel to go. If you want, you can. You don't have to. I can't get super chats or anything like that, so I don't really give a damn anymore. But I am trying to get my views up as well. So don't forget to like, subscribe, because that algorithm does help those views grow. And that way I can go back to earning some money off YouTube for making all these videos, because it does cost sometimes to do these videos. And it takes time. Like this morning, just this, I've been doing this since about, I forget what time it was that I started, because it wasn't that long ago. I think it was early hours of this morning. Started doing this. I couldn't sleep, so I got up and I started doing this. And I've most probably sunk, a good 10 hours, 8 to 10 hours into this video alone. So, yeah, it does take time, and some videos cost money as well. But, you can. You don't have to. It's up to you. It's sort of, I don't really care. I haven't made any money out of YouTube for so damn long. It doesn't even worry me any bloody more. But there, those of you in America, look into this yourselves and everything. And if anybody else out there in America can find the laws for me, send it to me via email. My email's in my About channel. And send it to me, and so that I can post it. If you find anything else on the laws in regard to this for other states, send it to me as well, and I'll stick it in the description. Thanks, guys, and I do apologise for turning that bloody page off, but as soon as I get off, I will be putting it into the description once I find it. Thanks very much, and have a good day and a good night, and don't forget to like and subscribe, and don't forget to click that bloody little bell at the thing, because you don't click the bell, you don't get notified. Anyhow, thanks, guys. I love yous all, and I shall see you all later. And before we go, who has been on the channel? We have had Mike, we have had Laura, we have had Mike again, and Loyalty. And that's a good name for you, darling, because you're one of my most loyal subscribers. And always on. If Loyalty sees me on, she's always in the channel. Thanks, darling. I'm going to catch up to you all later. All right, I'm out of here. Because I'd say my chemist delivery is almost here. And I can finally get some antibiotics in myself. Most probably, I'll tell you now, it's not COVID. I've been tested for COVID, but tell you now, it's knocking the shit.